Yes. So, is the screen visible to you all?
Yes,
Yes, sir.
sir.
So, I welcome all of you for this AICT sponsored Prerna scheme under which we are organizing such the lectures of for the preparation of GATE for the subject design and analysis of algorithm, and a top topic that we are going to discuss today is graph traversal techniques. As I already introduced myself, my name is Sarvesh Varjulkar, working as assistant professor in the Department of Information Technology of Gaikwad Patil College of Engineering and Technology, Nagpur, that is TGPCET, Nagpur. Now, the breadth-first search, as if we all know that the graph traversal technique is broadly divided into three different categories. First is breadth-first search, another is depth-first search, and third one is best-first search. In which, firstly, we are going to see in today's lecture about this breadth-first search technique. The topics that we are going to cover it today in today's class, they are introduction about breadth-first search, the definitions and everything related to breadth-first search, where there are various necessary terms that we are definitely going to use while the studying is going, while the lecture is going on, or while the topic is going on, that we'll cover. Then BFS, that is breadth-first search illustrations, with the help of example. I have one example which can help you out in all the possible ways. The pseudocode of breadth-first search, one Java program and it along with its output for breadth-first search. One algorithm with the help of any example, various applications of breadth-first search, how to use it, when to use it, what are the various basic applications of breadth-first search that we are also going to take in this today's class. Conclusion and the questions. I also have one or two questions related to the topic breadth-first search, which were asked in previous year's GATE question paper. So we will again discuss that topic in that question part. So this is the basic outline of this today's class. First of all, as if when we are going to enter in any of the subject, we should be aware about the history of that subject. We should be aware about the history of that topic as well. Now, what is breadth-first search? Breadth-first search is an, and its application is finding connected components of graph. Finding,
Excuse me,
yes.
sir. Whoa, screen freezing.
Is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is the outline that we have already discussed about the today's class, that we are going to discuss it in today's class. Next, the inventor of breadth-first search, basically breadth-first search is an and its application in finding connected components of a graph. It deals with the, as if it is the traversal technique in the graph. So ultimately, it is simply like we have to find the connected components of a graph. It means that we have to traverse the graph in the best possible way. Where originally invented in 1945 by Sir Conard Jess, he invented the technique of breadth-first search in the year 1945. He was a German civil engineer and inventor of computer pioneer. His greatest achievement was the world first programmable computer. And directly imagine the greatness of this great personality. Okay, come back to the original topic, that is breadth-first search. Breakfast search is an algorithm for traversing or searching tree or graph data structure. As we all know, a particular graph is a combination of is constituted by the combination of vertices and edges. There are n number of different topics, different types of graph, as you know, directed graph, undirected graph, weighted graph, unweighted graph, so on so forth. But the design or the construction consists of vertices and edges. We'll call it as the graph. There are connected graph, and not connected graph, disconnected graph, complete graph. Various types of graphs are also there. Am I audible?
Sir, audible. Yes, sir. Yes, yes sir.
So due to power cut off, the connection was get lost. I hope the screen is visible.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So there are various different types of graphs that we have already discussed. It starts at the tree root or some arbitrary node of the graph. As we know, arbitrary node means any of the random node in the graph. Any of the random node in the graph. Sometimes it referred as a search key and explores all the neighbor nodes at the present depth prior to moving on the nodes at the next depth level. Many of the times, the breadth first search is also called it as the level order search. Imagine a graph like this. A graph G, which consists of vertices and edges, consists of a set of vertices V and the edges E. As you know, edge is the connection between the two different nodes. Yahan pe, if we are seeing like this, 0 to 4 there is one edge, 0 to 1 there is one edge, 1 to 4 is also connected with the help of edge, 4 to 3 is connected with the help of one edge, 1 to 3 is there, 3 to 2 is there, and 1 to 2 is there. Then the number of vertices over here are 5. What are they? They are 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. They are the vertices, and the connection and the line to connect between them is called it as the edge of a particular graph. In the diagram given at the bottom of the screen, a tree is a collection of entities called nodes. Nodes are connected by edges. There, each node contains a value or a data, and it may or may not have a child node. If it is a construction of trees, the node which is always at the top is called it as the root node. And the nodes are connected by the various edges, where each node contains a value or a data. and it may or may not have a child node. Of course, the node number 5 in this diagram is having two different child nodes. We can say it as 3 and 8 are the child nodes of root node 5. Then they are again having some childrens. 1, 4, 7 and 10 are the childrens, are the child, or we will call them as the leaf nodes also. As if they don't have any different childs, so they are the dead end of, they are the leaf node of that particular tree. What we should know, these are the terminologies where we are going to use. Visiting a vertex, it means that, it means going on a particular vertex or checking a vertex value. To scan a particular vertex is again nothing but visiting a vertex. Exploration of vertex, it means visiting all the adjacent vertices of the selected node, or the adjacent vertices of the selected node. If there are any number of, in this diagram, if there are any different number of nodes, if I scan first 0, then I entered in the next layer or next level 1. The nodes which are beside the value 1, the nodes which are beside the node 1 are 2. The nodes which are beside the node 1 are 2 and 3 also. We are scanning this node by using the technique breadth first search. It's called it as exploration of vertex. Next, traversing. Traversing means passing through the nodes in a specific order. Yes, the very important word is specific order. If you are given, like, if you have to scan, or if you have to traverse the nodes, or if you have to traverse the graph, you should follow a specific order. It may be depth first search, it may be breadth first search, it may be best first search, whatever it may be. That traversing technique, it means that passing through the nodes in a specific order. Level order is also the part of different searching technique or traversing technique, where it is a traversing method where we have to visit every node on a level before going to the lower level. Like in the diagram on the right hand side of the screen. Firstly, if I am going to scan it, or if I am going to visit it or traverse it by using the breadth first search, first of all, I am directly pointing out to the root node, which is at the level 0, which is already at the always at the level 0. That level 0, I have to find it out. Firstly, I am going to scan this particular layer or this particular level while traversing for the breadth first search algorithm. Definitely, when I scan 0, my cursor goes from left to right in this diagram, left to right by scanning 0. Then again come back to the next level and on the left hand side. Then it may scan 1, 2 and 3 like this. My scanning is already in the layered order. My scanning is already in the level order. My scanning is already in the breadth way. Firstly, it scans layer 0, then it scans layer 1 or level 1. And again, in the last, it scans the remaining 4 layer, the remaining 4 nodes which are present in the layer 2 or which are present in the level 2 from left to right direction. From left to right direction. Therefore, it may be a level order scan or breadth first search or level order search as well. Breadth means, the question arises, breadth means the distance or measurement from the side of some, from side to side of something. it directly means that if any of the node is there, if there are beside some nodes present, if there are beside some nodes are present, we have to scan, or we have to check, or we have to traverse that node first. Means width, wideness, diameter, range, or any other extent. Breadth first search for a graph is similar to the breadth first traversal of a tree. Exactly. As you know, all the nodes are not connected, but in the graph all the nodes are connected somewhere else. The only catch here is, unlike trees, graph may contain cycle, of course, that I already discussed just now. Graph may contain cycle, but tree may not contain cycles, cause there are some disconnected type of nodes in the tree are there, as if the child nodes are there. They don't have any nodes connected between in them and connected with them except their parent nodes. So we may come to the same node again. To avoid processing a node more than once, we use a Boolean visited array. For simplicity, it is assumed that all vertices are reachable from the starting vertex. Assume that all vertices are reachable from the starting vertex. For example, yes, graph which is given on the start direction from as consider as when we come to vertex zero, we look for the adjacent vertex of there are adjacent vertex of the node zero. There are one and two again. If we don't mark two, we proceed again. Cause this is a loop. Is a loop 2 2 0 0 2 2 2 0 0 2. It might happen again and again. So if we start from node number 2 and when we visited to the node 0, then definitely we have to mention that we have visited node number 2 and node number 0. And after that there might be any of the thing. We can search it by level order. As you know, 2, say, connected the nodes which are connected to 2 we have visited first, that is 2 to 0, and breadth order means 2, the adjacent of 2 are again 3, and then last node, the only node remaining in the next level is 1. Rotate the diagram where 2 might be at the top. Rotate the diagram in a clockwise manner where 2 might be at the top. Then the breadth first search traversal for the following graph will be 2, 0, 3 and 1, accordingly from left to right. Same thing, the BFS or level order example is like this. If you are given a tree and the question in the gate exam will be, what will be the position of element number 9? What will be the position of element number 9 for the tree shown below by using breadth first search technique? The four options: position number 1, position number 8, position number 9, position number 10. The answer will be like this. Firstly, the cursor may scan 1. Firstly, the cursor may scan 1, then the cursor may scan 2, 3, 4, then the cursor may again scan 5, 6, 7, 8 by level order or by breadth first search. Again, come back to the left hand side, 9, 10, 11, 12. Accordingly, we'll find the value, or we'll find the position for the node 9 is 9. So the answer for such this question is 9, the position 9. Accordingly, we have to do the breakfast search technique. Some illustration with the help of an example that I have mentioned over here. As if, look at the figure one. Look at the figure one. One will be considered as a root node. There are six different nodes. And in the next box, in this, in over here, the visited node I have mentioned. Visited node I have mentioned. In the first, in the figure number one, I didn't have visited any of the node. Where in the figure number two, I start from node number one. And I visited node number one. So I mentioned visited one queue. And I put it into the queue. As you know, queue follows the property of first in, first out. The element which inserts in the queue, the element which comes in the queue first should implement first or should get out first. It follows the property of first in, first out. Next, in the figure number three, if I visited queue, there are no any elements beside the node number one in that level. So I also printed the value one or the node one in the figure number three. Look over here in the figure number three. Next, when I visited the next level of this tree, of this graph, the next level, there are two different nodes, node number two and node number three. Scans it from left to right. After visiting from one, we are standing on the left hand side of the of our left hand side, so that we can definitely scan two and three. It means we have visited node two, we have entered it in one. We have visited three, entered it one. Accordingly, in the queue, the elements will get inserted. So we can definitely print it out in the next slot like this. Print queue into the queue. They are already mentioned two and three. Then next print two and next print three. Accordingly, in the very next step, we'll enter into the four and five. Four we have entered already in the last step. Five over here we have mentioned. So accordingly, that level number 0, 1 and 2, level number two, we get search it on from left to right, and we have scanned it from left to right. We have mentioned it into the queue from left to right, and we have printed it again from left to right direction. In the last step, figure number nine, we have scanned element number six. We have visited node number six, and that is the reason we have put it one over here for visiting. Next, in the last answer diagram, the nodes should be printed like this. I have mentioned it by orange color, the visited nodes, and the non-visited node, I have mentioned it with the help of blue color in the diagram above. So print nodes are like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. BFS is just like a level order, and it follow three different rules. If you want, you can mention the rules also. Rule number one is visit the adjacent unvisited vertex. Visit the adjacent unvisited vertex. Make it as visited. Insert it into the queue and display it or print it. Visit the adjacent unvisited vertex. Mark it visited. Insert it in a queue and display it. Rule number two is, if there are no adjacent vertexes found, remove the first vertex from the queue. Rule number three, repeat rule one and rule two until the queue is empty. As if we know that the element which is inserted into the queue should be printed first. The element which is inserted in the queue should be printed first or should be displayed first, as if the property of Q is Q Q follows one property, that is, the element which inserted first should exit first, that is, first in, first out. Next. With the help of this particular diagram also, we will try to get the things accordingly. As if, consider it any of the node as a root node, arbitrary node, we can say. In the very first thing, we start it with node A. Node A, consider it as a root node, where there are no any nodes present in this level A. Tilt the diagram a bit so that E and C are at the same level, because the nodes which are connected to the node A are E and C. So accordingly, into the level, firstly we are going to scan A. That's why I mentioned over here A. I already scripted like there are six different nodes that I have to visit. So I have mentioned I have to scan all the six nodes which are present over here. In the first diagram, I scan node number A and I visit it and mark and enqueue A as option over here. Next. Then I remove it from the queue and I put it into the print location, because that level A is already clear and that level A is already visited. The node number A is already visited. Second, then I come to the node C and I visited, I entered it into the queue and mark it and enqueue into the list. After that, E is there. Why? Because the beside element of the node A are E and C. The connected element from the node A are E and C. So mark and enqueue E over here. BQC, of course, if there are the print, the level is completed. There are no different elements into the level 1. Level 0 is A, level 1 is E and C. So we have already scanned that thing. Level 2 will come there into the play now, because there are two different nodes connected with node number C. Basically, there are three different nodes, but F is also connected to D. So we can't take it into the level number 3 or level number 2 over here. So the nodes which are connected to C are B and D. The nodes which are connected to C are B and D. Firstly, we scan B. We entered or enqueue it into the node, into the queue, by applying the breadth first search algorithm. B is automatically get mentioned in that diagram, in that queue. Then enqueue D. Mark visited and enqueue D also. Then, of course, the element which comes first should remove first. That means E should get removed first, B should get removed afterwards, and then when entered, F into the queue. Likewise, we are going to remove E, B, D, and F. Ultimately, all the nodes get visited, and you might get the level order search should be like this. For the breadth first search for the given diagram, and the breadth first search is like A E C B B F, exactly like this. Your printed answer should be there. The pseudocode which is given for this diagram is mentioned over here, and as we have already discussed that the program for the breadth first search, by using this Java programming, the breadth first search is like this. Firstly, we have to create the class graph, and we have to enter the vertices, adjacent vertices, and accordingly, by applying the breadth first search technique, we have to mention such conditions, and so that it may follow all the different edges, all the different vertices, and according to the graph, according to the algorithm. The output of this diagram also, that diagram that I have already discussed at the very beginning of this PowerPoint presentation, create or start from the root number 2, from root number 2. I already said that rotate the diagram in a clockwise manner, you might get look like this. 2 will be the root node, 0 and 3 are the childrens of node 2, and 1 is again connected somewhere with 0. So there are 3 different levels, level 0, level 1 and level 2. So firstly we can scan level 0, that is element number 2. Then again on the left hand side we may scan 0 and 3. Again on the left hand side the cursor will be there on the left hand side. If there are no edges, no any vertices, it may not scan anything. But if there are any vertices, they have to scan in this level number 2. So firstly the element 2 is visited first, then 0, then 3 and then 1. The build is successful applying those algorithm technique. Next, the applications of breadth first search are, there are many applications of breadth first search. Let's discuss some of them. Shortest path or minimum spanning tree for the unweighted graph. For the various levels of the particular graph which is given to you, it may be for tree as well. In an unweighted graph, the shortest path is the path which with least number of edges. With breadth first search, we always reach a vertex from the given source using the minimum number of edges. We are, as if we are going to learn about the subject design and analysis of algorithm, definitely we might get we are very interested in optimal way, very interested in optimal way everywhere. That optimal way is nothing but minimum way or weight, where we have to scan all the vertices and edges with lowest possible way or with minimum cost spanning tree type of things will be there. Also in case of weighted graph, any spanning tree is minimum spanning tree, and we can use breadth first search traversal for finding a spanning tree. Second application is peer-to-peer networks. In peer-to-peer networks like BitTorrent, breadth first search is used to find neighbor nodes. Whatever the various neighbor nodes are there, the BFS is ready to find it out, all the different neighbor nodes. Ford Fuckerson method for computing the maximum flow in the flow network is also the application of this breadth first search. Crawls in search engines, as you know that Google is the search engine, there are various crawls, build index using breadth first search technique. This idea, as we also follow the same thing, that if I am going to enter how to in Google, it may gives me some sort of abbreviations behind or below in that search URL tab, so that it may also find what is the best possible way of searching from this particular IP address. Accordingly, it may gives me the relevant type of searching things. Social networking website is again the application. Some GPS navigation systems are again the various applications of this breadth first search. A city can be represented as a graph by taking landmarks as nodes and the roads as an edge. I mean, the navigation system also follow breadth first search technique for the searching process or for the searching technique in any of the graph over here. Next, broadcasting in network, in garbage collection, cycle detection in undirected graph, some path finding. There are n number of applications for breadth first search. Effective applications, I repeat. Broadcasting the network, your various broadcasting companies like networking websites, n number of things also follow such type of broadcasting in their network by using the breadth first search algorithm. In garbage collection, copying garbage collection, some cycle detection in undirected graph, like if the graph as if we have already mentioned that green 2013, that graph, there is one loop or cycle. If we start from 2 to 0, again there is an edge which comes from 0 to 2. That means to represent the cycle or to create, to avoid the cycle, we are definitely using this particular type of algorithm or this particular searching technique algorithm in the file while traversing it in the graph. Yes, the time and space complexity for the BFS is order of vertices plus edges, that is big O of vertices plus edges, where V is the number of nodes and E is the number of edges. We may stands for V as a vertices, nodes and vertices is one and the same thing. The space complexity, it means the memory required to store, that can be expressed as order of V only, cause we don't enter or we don't mention the edges anywhere in the diagram or while traversing the particular graph or tree by using this breadth first search technique. So only the thing we are going to enter in the memory space is vertices or nodes. So the time complexity, the space complexity for the breadth first search technique is big O of vertices, where V is the cardinality of the set of vertices. Next. The conclusion part is into the action, where breadth first search algorithm is very important algorithm that traverses a graph in the breadthward motion and uses the queue, that is first in first out. Remember, to get the next vertex to start a search when a dead end occurs in any iteration, breadth first search produces so called breadth first tree. And it is the same as level order search or level order traversing method. Breadth first search can be used to solve many problems in graph theory. It can also be applied to solve many real life problems that we have already discussed. GPS navigation, some computer networks, some social websites, structures, search engine structures, web crawlers, for search engine, etc., that we have already discussed in the previous slide. That is why a computer engineer, we should have a proper knowledge of breadth first search, the essential knowledge of breadth first search that I have already given it to you all. Next, any questions from your side? If you have any questions, you may ask. Otherwise, I have one question for you. That question was there in the previous year's GATE examination. I am going to show that question to you so that you might get solid, and as a part of token, you may give me the correct answer. The answer is in front of you. The options are in front of you. Definitely, you have to choose it, the proper answer. The question is like this. Breadth first search technique, solve it by using breadth first search technique. And mention your answer in the chat box. This is the previous year GATE question paper problem, which came on breadth first search technique. I hope you have got the answer. There is a quite ambiguity in between the option C and D, and the correct answer by applying the breadth first search technique for this given diagram is C. I am giving you the explanation like this. Option A is MNOPQR. It cannot be the BFS as the traversal starts with M, but O is visited before N and Q. O is visited before N and Q. It is not at all possible. After visited M, there is no any direct connection from M to O. So this is not possible. Next, in BFS, all adjacent, yes, as if the rule of BFS, all adjacent nodes must be visited before the before adjacent of adjacent. Option B is NQMPOR. It also cannot be the BFS because here P is visited before O. P should be visited after the next algo, next different nodes. C and D is having the competition in between two. That is, Q is the root node. First of all, Q is the root node, and from Q we start Q, M, and N. After visiting Q, M, and N, P is there into the next, in that next order. After that, there is a lot bit confusion between O and R, where to visit O and where to visit R. The only answer is like this. We see that M was added to the queue before N and P because M comes before NP in Q, M, and P, as we have already mentioned, because R is M's neighbor. Look at the diagram properly. The neighbor of R is M. It means the adjacent vertices of R is M. So accordingly, it gets added to the queue before the neighbor of N and P. Before the neighbor of N and P, the neighbor of N and P is O. It should be added before it because it is the neighbor of, it is the adjacent vertices of, adjacent vertex of node M. So it mentioned before it. So ultimately, the R is visited before O, and the correct answer for this given diagram is option number C, QMNPR and O. If you want, you can take the screenshot of this given diagram. If you have any questions, you may ask it me personally, you may ask it to me on my WhatsApp or anywhere else. So I think I'm going to stop the recording.